In the second part of our webinar, devoted to memory usage in Firebird, we will discuss how to tune memory consumption and discuss optimal values for various Firebird configuration parameters related with memory. We need to tune the size of Firebird processes and file cache usage in order to align them with the operation system defaults for paged memory and file cache. Let's start with the tuning of the size of Firebird processes and discuss available parameters. As you remember, in the first part of our webinar, we have found that each Firebird process, like FB, Net Server XE or Firebird XE, internally uses memory for the several purposes. And we can tune memory consumption for three of them, for page cache, memory for sorting, and log table. So let's discuss them in details. What do they mean, how to change them, and what are recommended values? The first is a page cache. Page cache, also called page buffers or buffers, is used to store frequently changed database pages. As you probably know, Firebird database internally consists of pages of the equal size, and each read or write operation is performed against the whole page, even only one bit is written or read. Page cache allocation also depends on Firebird architecture. For classic and super classic, the specified number of database pages will be allocated for each client connection, and for super server for all connections. So, how to calculate page cache size? In order to calculate the actual memory usage for the page cache, it is necessary to multiply the specified number of page buffers by the page size of the database. For example, default value for super server in Firebird 2.5 is 2048 pages. So the page cache size for all connections will be around 8 megabytes. For classic, default value is 75 pages. And for each connection, cache will be around 300 kilobytes. Of course, default values are low, are very low, and we need to increase them. There are three ways to change the page cache. The recommended way is to change the parameter default DB cache pages in Firebird configuration file. Please note, this parameter will be applied to all databases on the server. The second way is to set value of page buffers directly in the header of the database using command gfix -buffers. Please note, this command will override the value set in default DB cache page parameter. And the third option. It is possible to set page buffers value in the properties of the specific client connection, but it is rarely used. So what are recommended size of page cache for Firebird? What values should be set to achieve the best performance? So there are differences in the recommended values between versions 2.5 and 3.0 of Firebird, and of course, differences between architectures. Firebird 2.5 Classic and Super Classic should have page cache set to the value between 500 pages and 2000 pages. In rare cases, with mostly read load, page cache for Classic or Super Classic could be up to 4,000 pages. Firebird 2.5 Super Server should have 10,000 pages. These recommendations are based on the multiple tests that we in IB Surgeon performed. For example, you can take a look on the 1.7 terabyte database performance tests. And also, of course, these recommendations are based on the experience that we have with many productions databases our company supports. So, as you can see, Fiber 2.5 is not eager to consume a lot of memory. The 100 users in Classic will consume only 3.2 gigabytes in case of 16 kilobytes page size. Fiber 3 has introduced the new revamped SuperServer architecture, which theoretically can consume all available memory for the page cache. However, as we remember from the first part of the webinar, we must align memory consumption with the expectations of operation system memory manager. In case of default Windows, for example, it means that maximum 50% of RAM can be used for paged memory, which includes Firebird process. In case of dedicated server, where the main business application is Firebird database, empirical limit for the Firebird free SuperServer page cache is 40% or less. On the majority of servers where Firebird should coexist with other applications, this value is about 25%. And as for Classic and Super Classic architectures in Firebird 3, recommendations are the same as for version 2.5. The next memory allocation we need to tune is memory for sorting. Every time you run query with group by, order by, distinct, and cplan sort, not for distinct of course, Firebird sorts appropriate values for the result set. Internally, Firebird allocates some memory to perform sorting in the inside the RAM. But if the size of the array to be sorted exceeds the Firebird configuration parameter temp cache limit, sort process will create a temp file on the disk. Of course, we would like to keep all data in the memory when on the slow disk. Firebird configuration parameter temp cache limit is specified in bytes, and by default its values are pretty low, 8 MB for Classic and 64 MB for Super Server and Super Classic. Of course, in case of Classic it's it means 8 MB for each connection. It is important to say that temp cache limit is allocated on demand. If the blocks increased by the blocks specified by temp cache block size parameter, which by default is 1 MB. Temp files are created in case if memory allocated for sorting is not enough to keep all data to be sorted, and Firebird will create temporary files. By default, it will create them in the temp folder of Windows or in TMP Firebird on Linux, or in the folders specified in temp directory parameter of Firebird configuration file. It is possible to monitor the number and size of sort files manually by, you know, looking and constantly refreshing the folder with temp files. The idea is to figure out what exact amount of memory is used for the sorting and increase temp cache limit accordingly to allow all sorted values to be in memory. Of course, it is not very convenient, and some advanced tools like IB Surgeon HQBird can be used to estimate the necessary amount of memory for sorting, so they monitor the temporary files automatically. HGBird also can show queries with amount of stored in memory exceeding the specified limit. So what are recommendations for temp cache limit? First of all, of course, we must increase default value because it is low. We need to monitor temp files for sorting to see actual size of arrays to be sorted. With that, we will understand how much memory we need to allocate in temp cache limit. And of course, we need to remember that operation system memory manager has implications. So the total size of paged memory should be less than 50% of Windows available RAM. And also we need to remember that the memory for sorting is allocated on demand. The third parameter, the third item we can tune is the size of the log table. Log table internally is intensively used by classic and super classic, and less intensively by super server. Log table is allocated for all Firebird processes. By default, its initial size is only 1 megabyte, but it grows on demand. However, the problem is the following. Every time the size of log table is increased, the whole log table is remapped. This operation is not fast. And the good idea is to set the initial size of log table to some high value. Ideally, it should be the value the log table has in the end of the workday. But just to give you idea about size of log tables, here is the example of log table from the database with slightly more than 1,000 users. You can see that its size is 68 megabytes. No, not much. But of course, it depends on the load profile, and the log table could be 200 megabytes for 1,000 users, and so it is all individual. But anyway, it is not that much comparing with temp cache limit values and page cache. So the idea of this tuning is just to set log table to some log table size to some high value. So let's review the parameters in Firebird configuration file related with memory tuning. We have discussed default DB cache pages, temp cache limit with temp block size, and log mem size parameters. The remaining two parameters are file system cache threshold and file system cache size, which are obviously related with file cache usage in the operation system. The parameter file system cache threshold in Firebird configuration file is designed to switch on or off the usage of the file cache for the database file. However, it does not have simple syntax like on or off. For some reason, it was designed to be a part of condition which enables or disables the usage of file cache for database file. Firebird compares value of page cache with value of file system cache threshold. And if page cache is less, Firebird will use the file cache of operation system for caching database file. If file system cache threshold is less than page cache, the operation system file cache will not be used. Please note that Firebird compares the actual value of page cache for the specific database, not the default DB cache page parameters. And also please remember that setting in the header of a database with gfx minus buffers overrides the setting in the Firebird conf with default DB cache page. File cache is critically important for architectures classic and super classic, so it should be always on for the classic and super classic Firebird instances. Obviously, there are often questions DBAs start to ask when they hear about the file cache is when the file cache can be disabled. Their logic is the following. A file cache is the layer between Firebird cache and the storage cache. So if we will remove it, theoretically, we can achieve faster read-write operations. However, practically, there are very few cases when file cache can be disabled to achieve better performance. Of course, it always should be a super server version of Firebird version 3. Usually, it should be a read-only database which will benefit from the disabled file cache, or database which fits into the page cache totally with very low percent of writes. The ratio between reads and writes can be found from monitoring table. Also, it is possible that database on SSD with low percent of writes can benefit from the disabled file cache. However, there is no direct recommendation to enable or disable file cache. The only recommendation is to always test this setting. So we are approaching the end of the webinar, and let's review the general recommendations for tuning memory on Windows. So the general rule, the total size of all processes, which includes Firebird, which in order includes page buffer, stamp cache limit, lock mem size, and so on, should be less than the paged memory, which is by default is 50% of RAM. Also, recommendation that file cache must be enabled for classic and super classic without exceptions, always enabled. And for super server, it should be enabled for large databases, which more than the size of available memory. Of course, there could be some tests, but default recommendation is to enable it. General recommendation for Linux a bit different, since Linux usually does not have a strict allocation about paged memory and file cache, it allows file cache to grow high and potentially it could occupy the whole memory. However, from our practice, the recommended percent for paged memory for processes should be no more than 50%, and usually it is even less. And of course, file cache must be enabled in all cases. We have prepared a set of optimized Firebird configuration files with unit parameters. These configuration files were tuned for the moderate amount of memory, but they could be a good starting point for the optimization. You can download it for free without any registration on our website. Here you can see the link. And thank you for your attention. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and thank you.